Water left out in the sun evaporates, gasoline evaporates, and black holes, yep, they do too. Hi there, you little quantum wiggles in space-time. Trace here for DNews. First things first, make sure you're sitting down for this episode, because things are about to get deep, like a supermassive black hole's gravitational well deep. So black holes. I think most of us have a pretty good idea about what a black hole is, even if we don't necessarily understand, you know, what it is. You know what I mean. Black holes are basically regions in the universe where physics flips us the bird and takes a holiday. They are regions that are so dense with matter that their gravity becomes so strong that even light cannot escape and the normal laws of physics no longer apply. They're made of two things, a dense, massive singularity and an event horizon, which is basically the point of no return, where gravity gets so high, nothing escapes. We will never know what lies between the event horizon and a singularity, unless you're Matthew McConaughey, I guess, as no information can escape past the event horizon. If you looked in, you'd be forever lost from the universe inside the who knows whatness that lies beyond. However, in recent decades, physicists have been debating the possibility that information can escape from a black hole via something called Hawking radiation, which throws a curveball into the classical model of black hole physics. British physics superhero Stephen Hawking started playing with this idea in the 1970s. He came to the conclusion that not only can information escape the black hole's clutches, it can also carry mass away from the black hole. Black holes that aren't gaining mass will eventually lose it and disappear or evaporate. Basically, this information is just electromagnetic radiation, like light. It's called information because it's encoded with information about what has fallen beyond the event horizon into the black hole, something we know nothing about. So taking this to its logical conclusion, black holes are not permanent features in the cosmos, because if they're not sucking in matter, they slowly evaporate and eventually disappear. This works because the vacuum of space isn't really a vacuum. We just did a video about how virtual particles pop in and out of existence. It's a quantum mechanics thing, and it's complicated, so just know that they do this, and that they do it in pairs. Those pairs pop into existence, and then hit each other and disappear. This is called annihilation. This is good because energy cannot be created and destroyed, and the math must balance. Because they annihilate, they don't break any law. Quantum law! I just love doing that. Sometimes these pairs will appear in that no man's land between the event horizon and the singularity of a black hole. In this situation, theoretical physicists think that one of the virtual particle pairs should fall into the black hole, while the partner of the pair is stuck on the other side all on its lonesome. We'll call this lonesome particle Jared. This is where things get interesting. According to quantum dynamics, that lonesome Jared particle is now stuck in our universe. It becomes real. It can't disappear again. It's no longer virtual. It's gifted with a mass and energy like Pinocchio turning from a wooden toy into a real boy. But to conserve energy, another pretty heavy physics law that has to be obeyed, the virtual particle that fell into the black hole must carry some kind of negative energy. Therefore, very slightly reducing the amount of energy inside of that black hole. The net effect is that the Jared particle, like a photon of radiation, is sent out of the black hole into space, and the black hole loses a little bit of mass. If this is continuously happening, and a black hole is no longer eating new mass, it will lose mass overall, and this is called evaporating. Scientists are currently looking for the gamma ray signal that would be generated each time one of these black holes pop out of existence, though we've actually never seen it happen yet. Also, scientists at the Large Hadron Collider are looking to create ultra-tiny micro black holes, which could fizzle out of existence really fast, helping us better understand this evaporating process. Though Hawking radiation is fun to consider, it has added fuel to the epic battle between general relativity and quantum dynamics, culminating in the black hole firewall paradox. But we probably should save that for another day. Speaking of the Large Hadron Collider, we visited this crazy particle accelerator to give you an inside look. Check it out.
So they collide about 25 nanoseconds. So you have a bunch colliding with another bunch. You may have a proton here and a proton here, which has a hard, what we call scattering, a hard event. And out of that comes out a whole mess of particles.
How's your brain feeling after all this? A little stretched, a little tough? Let us know down in the comments if you want us to do more of these videos, and keep watching so you get more DNews.